Are you right now at the verge of giving up on life? Do you battle condemnation and feel inadequate? Is there a part of you that doubts whether God truly loves you? Would you like to better comprehend God's love for you? Life is full of uncertainties, but in God, there is an assurance of a beautiful future. Be inspired as you receive God's word that will stir up faith and confidence in the love that God has for you. Join us today on The Covenant Light.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Welcome to The Covenant Light. Today, go ahead, send out these links to as many people as you can. And join me and let's have a time in God's presence. Hallelujah. Jesus, set me free. And look at the wounds that give me life. Grace flowing from inside. No greater sacrifice. What is done? Forgiven, my future is heaven. I praise God for what He's done.
Sing for the freedom He has won. Even death is dead and done. His life has overcome.
Hallelujah. I praise God for what He has done. My sins are forgiven. My future is heaven. Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask for revelation knowledge to dawn upon our hearts once again today. Let words and thoughts from heaven flow freely through me to your people. Let these words and thoughts continue to speak to us beyond this time, until there is fruit and manifestation. And Lord, let signs and wonders be done in the lives of those who hear me. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. So we have been talking about doing great. Yesterday I titled this, "How are you doing? Great?" You know, it's a question we ask each other often. How are you doing? And then we always say great or good. Well, as we begin to prepare for 2023, you know, the Lord had spoken to me and said it to be a year where his people experience enduring greatness. In other words, we will begin the journey into greatness. We will step into greatness and enduring. So it's beyond 2023. It will continue. However, there were certain instructions and that the Lord gave us. And yesterday we were looking at the fact that we need to ensure greatness in the things we do. We need to do great. Okay? And so our text this week has been Ecclesiastes chapter 9 from verse 10. Ecclesiastes chapter 9 from verse 10. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with your might. For there is no work or device or knowledge or wisdom in the grave where you are going. I returned, verse 11, and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, nor bread to the wise, nor riches to men of understanding, nor favor to men of skill, but time and chance happen to them all. In other words, that a person is swift does not guarantee that he will win the race. At the moment when the time to win the race and the chance or opportunity to win the race, to run that race, when it shows up, he has to do great at that time. What this passage is telling us is that it's not about whether you can, it's whether you did. The swift can run fast, but when the gun went off and it was time to run, did he run fast? The strong can fight a battle, but when the opportunity and the time to fight showed up, you see, time and chance happens, and that's what determines everything. When the time to fight and the opportunity to fight a battle showed up, did he fight? Did he fight to the fullest?